Yes.
Hola, ¿cómo le va? Bienvenido a Yes, la nueva forma de acercarse al inglés. Usted sabe que el otro día estaba mirando una película y uno de los actores dijo, ¡qué asco! Y yo me quedé pensando, ¿cómo lo habrán dicho en inglés? What did they say? Bueno, ahí va la primera.
Aquí tienes, tal como te gusta. Qué asco.
Bueno, el tema es aquí tienes. No trate de hacer una traducción literal. Y ese qué asco, piense en algo así como desagradable. A ver.
Here you go, just the way you like it. Disgusting.
Claro que sí. Es muy usual. Lo escuchamos de nuevo.
Here you go, just the way you like it. Disgusting.
Bueno, esta es muy fácil, escúchela.
Permiso, permiso.
De nuevo.
Excuse me, excuse me.
Una más.
Le prometí a una amiga que te saludaría el día de hoy.
Bueno, aquí tal vez el tema es saludaría. Usted piense en diría hola. La escuchamos en inglés.
Promise, my friend. I will say hello to you today.
De nuevo.
Promise, my friend. I will say hello to you today.
Y la última.
Por favor, salúdame.
Bueno, aquí piense en dime hola. A ver.
Please say hello to me.
Una vez más.
Please say hello to me.
Ahora voy a compartir con usted oraciones que incluyen errores y bueno, la idea es que usted los descubra. Spot the mistake. Bueno, esta es realmente fácil. Vamos con la primera. On Sunday, I work with he. Corríjala. Bien, him. He bought she a cup of coffee. Claro, usted no dice he bought he. He bought her. George is having lunch with they. Qué horrible. ¿Cómo sería? With them. Una más. Can you accompany I to the baker's? Bueno, me hace mal decirlo. Sería, can you accompany me to the baker's?
Le deletreo cuatro palabras y usted me dice de qué término se trata. Spelling.
He is E N G L I S H English.
He's got an
O W L
Owl.
He likes M
A
G I
C
Magic.
His name is
H
A
R R Y Harry.
Si le parece, seguimos incrementando nuestra lista de outsiders.
Sinónimo de estrella o deportista de gran habilidad. 5 seconds.
Crack. Tipo de droga de alta adicción derivada de la cocaína. 5 seconds.
crack.
Acompáñeme al teatro para aprender vocabulario. Video Dictionary.
Bueno, este señor está tocando una trompeta. ¿Cómo se dice trompeta en inglés? Esos son bailarines que están sobre el escenario. Algunas de las bailarinas tienen plumas. ¿Cómo se dice plumas? ¿Se acuerda? Esa es una orquesta. Bueno, y ahí la gente está aplaudiendo. Vamos con la trompeta. Trumpet, claro que sí. Dancers. Escenario. Bien. Stage. Plumas. Feathers. Hasta ahí vamos muy bien. Cuidado con la pronunciación de orquesta. Orchestra. Y ellos están aplaudiendo. They are applauding.
El pobre era ciego como un topo. ¿Conoce la expresión? ¿La sabe en inglés? Words and phrases.
En castellano, ciego como un topo. ¿Cuál será el equivalente en inglés? Ahí tiene las palabras. Bad, as, a, blind, as. Es fácil, ¿eh? Una ayudita. As blind, tan ciego, as a bat. Literalmente, tan ciego como un murciélago.
Ahora le voy a pedir que encuentre sinónimos para las palabras que va a ver en pantalla. Y de paso, prueba su inglés. Test your English.
Bueno, ahí vamos entonces con los sinónimos. O palabras con significados muy parecidos en realidad. Tenemos fat, thin, shy, careless. Y los sinónimos serían timid, plump, slim, thoughtless. A ver, vaya relacionando. ¿Qué le parece fat? Claro, eso es gordo. Y plump es algo así, gordito, regordete. Esa sería la palabra más parecida en significado. Thin. ¿Cuál dijo? Slim, correcto. Thin es delgado, slim esbelto. Shy. ¿Qué significa shy? ¿Cuál? Esa. Tímido. Y timid sería la correcta. Aunque debo reconocer que timid tiene un poquito más que ver con asustadizo que con tímido. Pero comparten cierta connotación. Careless. Descuidado es muy similar a thoughtless, que significa desconsiderado, inconsciente, alguien que no piensa.
En inglés británico, a un tipo de masitas o galletitas se las conoce como biscuits. Ahora, ¿sabe usted cuál es el origen de este término? Word origins.
Bueno, ¿de dónde viene entonces la palabra biscuit? ¿French City? ¿Nombre de la ciudad donde se las elaboró por primera vez? ¿Qué dice usted? ¿Biscuit? ¿Términos franceses? ¿O trademark? ¿O fue una marca comercial? Bueno, justamente biscuit, esa es la correcta. Biscuit en francés significa cocinado dos veces y justamente ese era el proceso al que se sometía al pan para mantenerlo en buenas condiciones en las épocas en que se realizaban largas travesías por mar.
Cuando empezamos a estudiar inglés, ya sea de niños, de adolescentes o de adultos, siempre aparece el verbo to be. El verbo to be es el verbo ser y estar. Usted lo conoce, es I am. Luego, you, we, they es are. Y he, she, it es is. Sepa también usted que ain't es una manera no formal de hacer el negativo del verbo to be y también del verbo to have. Pero recuerde que es informal. Bueno, yo ahora voy a compartir con usted una canción y le voy a pedir que complete el texto con el verbo to be and sing a song.
Versión original, sing a song.
This town is cold enough, I think it's sick of us. It's time to make a move, I'm shaking off the rust. I've got my heart set on anywhere but here. I'm staring down my shelf, counting up the years. Steady.
Hace algunos años tuve el placer de hacerle una entrevista a la señora Nacha Guevara, pero de una manera diferente. La hice en inglés. Y bueno, usted nos pidió muchas veces que la repitiésemos y este es el momento. Hoy tenemos la primera parte de la entrevista a la señora Nacha Guevara en inglés con subtítulos y la semana que viene la segunda parte. Bueno, usted posiblemente la vio en el cine, la vio en televisión, la vio en el teatro. Disfrutó de sus canciones, pero no sé si la escuchó hablar inglés. Hoy tiene la oportunidad con nosotros la señora Nacha Guevara, but in English, in yes. So, practice and do some listening. Nacha, welcome.
Hello, how are you?
But that must be very weird for you to be doing this in English.
Quite weird, yes.
Well, first of all, thank you very much for having come. No, it's a great pleasure for us to have you here.
For having me.
Okay. So, the question is, my first question is, how did the English language help you in your career? Because, well, you've talked English for quite a while.
Oh, yes. I lived in
the United States?
Yes. So, I had to speak English, even if you're not an American. Nowadays, you have to speak English.
Oh, yes.
So when I was in exile,
yeah,
I after a long journey from country to country, I arrived to USA. And then I knew a little English,
mm-hmm.
but my second language was French. So I had to learn there.
Mm.
I woke up every morning very early and I went to school. It was...
That was in New York?
In New York. 46th and Park Avenue. Mm.
And well, the Park Avenue is a beautiful place.
Yes, it was a beautiful place, but the neighborhood was beautiful, not the school.
Yeah.
And I had there like 4 hours a day. Mm-hmm. And we had different teachers for different
subjects
yep. Like idioms, prepositions, conversation. Okay, so I was there for quite a while, like 6 months or so, and then when I began performing, I had to be more specific about the language.
I see.
I went to Berlitz School, and yeah. I had a teacher every day, 2 hours. Conversation and
phonetics,
accent.
Yep.
Oh my yeah. God.
Oh yeah. I imagine the different sounds.
I felt like Eliza Doolittle in yeah. Muffin Lady.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
And you remember the flame with the H and all that.
It was a torture.
It was a torture.
But it was good.
It was good.
And then I performed in English a lot.
Oh really?
My shows were like at the end. Were like 70%
in English,
and oh, I had my reviews. They said she does it very well in English.
Oh, so, lovely,
yeah.
Lovely.
But I have lost a lot because I don't talk
anymore. Very much.
I have to tell you a secret. I have some lessons. I am his pupil.
Well, I'm very
some lessons with him.
I'm very proud. I mean, you are one of my students. Very proud, and you're an excellent student. On the other hand, there were people you had to talk to in English, and who, in a way, represented a lot in your life. Like, for example, Harold Prince.
Oh yes.
What can you tell us about him? I mean, because you had to talk English to him.
Oh yes. That's the only, they don't speak many languages,
yes.
American people, they don't need it. So you have to go for them in English.
Yeah, absolutely.
So he's a wonderful person. He was my artistic advisor for 3 years.
Yep.
And when I go back to New York, I live with them, with the family. I'm part of their family, the
really?
Prince's family. Oh. Yes. And... Well, it was a wonderful experience, and really, they don't mind so much about the accent in
yep.
New York. I'm talking
no,
about
no, no.
New
it's
York.
The communication.
If you can convey
yep.
what you want to say, and also they want to be to have different people with personalities.
Oh yeah, I see.
So they forgive you everything if you're different.
Yeah, but there are not too many things to forgive in your case, Nacha, please.
You bet.
Julie Christie.
Julie Christie.
You talked English to Julie Christie when
oh,
you
yes.
did Miss Mary.
Yes, and I had to learn a little of British accent. I had a coach.
Yeah.
So I worked with that coach, my lines to be more British than American, because as I learned in New York and
yep.
I was living there for a while, my accent tended to be
American. Yeah, to be American.
So she's a wonderful lady, and we are both vegetarians.
Ah, yeah.
So our friendship began that way, because
yeah.
we ate together during the making of the movie. And she fell in love with Argentina.
Oh yeah.
And she was there after the movie was made. She was here for like 6 months.
Yeah.
Nobody knew. I mean, the press didn't know.
She came 5 months before. I mean, they began to shoot the film.
No.
She remained afterwards.
Yes.
Ah, yeah.
When the movie was finished.
Oh yeah.
And she was all over the country by herself. She's a wonderful person, a wonderful actress. And so generous as a performer.
Oh, yeah.
She was very helpful.
Yeah, that's very nice.
Yeah.
That's very nice. If you had to rescue one of, was there any show of yours you particularly liked or you liked best? Because I assume that it's always the last one, but when you look back, perhaps there is one you remember with love.
Well, all of them, but when I came back from exile, it was very meaningful, the whole experience. I mm-hmm. came from New York. I was working with Hal Prince a lot.
Mm.
I learned a lot from him. I had the privilege of working
with
him. Yeah.
Well, you were chosen
him.
By him.
Oh, yes.
He called you.
Yes, but at the same time, we became friends. When he was preparing some musicals like Sweeney Todd Nora's Nora's life, the saga of what's the name in
oh, you can say it in Spanish, don't worry.
I don't remember.
You remember either, okay. Doesn't matter.
So I was with him during the whole process, you could say as a watcher.
Yep.
So I was with him when he was building the maqueta.
Ah, yeah.
And when during rehearsals, yeah. And with Steve Sondheim, when they're preparing the song. So I learned a lot. And when I came back, I came with that whole experience. And my first show was Aquí Estoy.
Uh-huh.
It's based on a Steve Sondheim song called I'm Still Here.
Oh, yeah.
And that was a very...
a very dear show to
dear
you.
And very close to perfection.
Oh,
that I love perfection.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, and the whole experience, being back, working again in Argentina, being again in touch with my audience. And every night, very moving things happened. The audiences were very expressive and said very lovely things, and they expressed that euphoria that we had at that moment, and also the love for me was incredible.
Why do you think you were chosen to perform Mrs. Robinson? Probably it's a question you've answered before, but never in English.
No, never in English. I don't know if I really
answered. Well, you don't know. Well, perhaps it was in English too.
Well, I had a story with the director.
Uh-huh.
Felipe del Paso.
Yeah, Mexican?
Mexican, but he's an art director in Hollywood. He was working a lot of time as an art director with Tarantino.
Uh-huh.
And then he was nominated for the Oscar for Frida. He was the art director for Frida. And many, many years ago, when I was in Mexico performing, he went to the theater one night. And he arrived late, and he opened the door, and he says that image he received in that moment, he was a student of law. He was becoming to be a lawyer.
A lawyer, yeah.
And the moment he saw that image, just the moment he entered the theater, he said, I'm not going to be a lawyer. I'm going to do this. I love what this woman does.
Oh.
So I didn't know that. Once in New York, I met him, he was with Salma Hayek, and he told me that. He said, I'm in this business because of you. I said, oh, thank you for telling me that, because you never know how you affect people's lives.
Oh, yes.
Okay. So, when they called me for the graduate, I read the book, I saw the
film?
DVD.
No, oh, yeah.
The DVD with the staging.
The staging he'd done in Mexico before.
He has done, yes.
Yeah.
And I found something familiar with the stagings I do. Kind of language, mm-hmm. similar language. And I asked to the producer here, I said, this guy, he wasn't, do you know if he was the director, the art director for Tarantino?
Mm.
And he said, no, I don't know. Okay. When I signed the contract, immediately the telephone rang, and he was there, singing my songs and so happy and telling me, do you know something? Once upon a time, I went to the theater and I opened the door and said, but you told me that. I was with you in New York. Do you remember that? Yes. So we had a very deep union.
Yeah, yeah, from some time before. Yes.
So he was always thinking of working with me. And I'm very grateful to him for calling me.
And it was a big success.
It was a big success, and it was a big experience working with him. His staging was beautiful.
Natch, I have the first difficult question.
Oh,
are you ready? Brace yourself.
I'm ready, and I'm trained because you're that often.
The question is this. What are the main differences between you and the character, Mrs. Robinson? Are there differences? Of course there
yes,
are.
Yes, differences and similarities.
That's it.
Okay. Differences are that I don't go naked.
In the street.
In another house. Because when she's naked, she's at the other family.
Yeah.
The Brad family.
Yeah.
She's
yeah.
incredible. Well,
yeah.
And also I don't drink.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't smoke.
Mm-hmm.
So
those are the differences.
Yes, the similarities are that I usually tend to say what I think and to act as I feel. Mm-hmm. And I have dated younger people.
Younger people.
So that those are the similarities and the differences between. And but you always have something
absolutely.
In common with every single living creature in this world.
Yeah, absolutely.
So actors have to grab to onto that.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have more differences than similarities with the character. So you have to grab
from those things to create.
You have in common with the character.
And I will ask you another difficult question, but I ask you not to answer it now.
You give me time to think about it.
I give you some minutes to think about
okay.
it. You are regarded as a difficult question. Person.
Person.
You are regarded as a difficult person. First of all, I'd like you to tell me what you understand by difficult. And secondly, if that is true. Yo voy a seguir hablando con Nadia. Pero la segunda parte de esta entrevista la vamos a tener la semana que viene en Yes. Yo espero que haya practicado. Tiene un excelente inglés. Usted ya lo escuchó. Yo soy Charlie López y me despido hasta la semana que viene en Yes. La nueva forma de acercarse al inglés.
Yes.